What's up, guys? This Disposable 762, and been having troubles finding me a holster for this old R8 Smith & Wesson right here. So I found a neoprene holster that I believe is going to work. So I'm going to have to modify it a little bit. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Just before the video starts, I'd like to promote my new t-shirt store at tpublic.com. At tpublic.com's website, if you go to the search bar and type in Disposable 762, you'll be able to find my t-shirt designs there. And I appreciate the business. I appreciate y'all watching these videos. I appreciate y'all subscribing. And I really would like to sell y'all some t-shirts, phone cases, stickers, whatever the case may be. You can select your different colors. You don't have to get these colors. You can get whatever color you want, and sizes, and women's sizes and stuff like that. These are just a couple of examples of my t-shirts that I figured I would come and show y'all. So I appreciate your business. I appreciate you watching the videos, and I appreciate your support. Remember, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, and we're gone. So here we go, guys. I want to take this holster here. I want to kind of size it up. I want to cut this out here. I know that's some good reinforcement right there, but I want to try this. Try to cut this out right here enough for that scope mount. So let's see here. I have misplaced my scissors. So we'll see if this here old hawkbill will work. It's a serrated blade, so right there. It's hard to beat them serrated blades, buddy. They cut good. All right. Let's see what this looks like. I'll go a little bit further, I believe. Not much further. Maybe right there. I'm going to go ahead and cut it off. Don't bring a knife toward you. I hear the safety Sally's hollering now. I believe that's gonna work, fellas. Just that thumb breaker a little bit. I believe that's got her. All right, now since I'm into this, also, I got a little other little project here that I wanted to use with this holster. And this is a very heavy duty belt right here. And the belt loop is not going to fit. So what I was thinking I could do was rivet that joker on there, because this is plastic right here. Put me some washers there. Let me think here. I don't believe it's gonna go. Let me see if it'll go before I even try to cipher something out. No, that's malt oil. Yeah, that's smaller than that part and it won't go. So what I'm gonna have to do is I think I'm gonna rivet this holster on here. See, make sure I rivet to the right side, huh? Yep, so it'll go on the thumb brake side. About right there, maybe. Actually, if I could get that through there, about right there is where I'd like to have it. Let's see if we can work it through there. Uh-oh. It might work. Look at there, buddy. Yes, sir. So I had a... This pistol came with a Kydex holster when I bought it off of a gun broker, and it didn't allow for the rail. I don't even think it allowed for that little laser right there. But that right there is cool. That is ready to go. The R8. I like that pistol, man. I shot it the other day, and really did enjoy shooting that pistol. There is something else I'd like to try right quick if I can. I want to make some kind of shell holder for these moon clips. I'm just going to practice here on something. See if we can't work these. And these here are just some steel rod that under your crawl space of your house would hold up the insulation there in your crawl space. That's all these are. Well, it might not be perfect, but it might be all right. I added this right here to my belt. I used to run my electrical tape like that. I believe I could stack me about 3 on there. I'm Disposable 762. Remember, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And we're gone.